Well, you know, lots of people say, if you're a new believer and you're asking, where do I start reading my Bible? Most people will say the Gospel of John. And I understand why that's true. The Gospel of John represents a historical account of the life of Jesus. Jesus is the most important person in the Bible. Jesus is the most important person in life. But it's not necessary that you start at the Gospel of John. For example, if you went down to a bookstore in the mall and bought a book, and you said to the owner, where should I start reading this book? He wouldn't say chapter 28, he'd say chapter 1. I don't see any reason why we shouldn't start right in Genesis chapter 1 and read right through the Bible. Now, admittedly, there are some portions of the Bible more difficult to read, more difficult to understand than others. But the great thing is the Spirit of God helps us understand even those difficult passages. I've been studying God's Word, speaking from God's Word, teaching God's Word for a lot of years, and there are things I still don't understand, things I probably never will understand. But I think the best way for a new person to God's Word, to really understand and read God's Word is three things, and they're a little bit corny, so forgive me. Number one, you need a book, and here it is right here, the Bible. Number two, you need a look. You need to actually open that Bible and read it. Most people don't know what God says because they've never read the Bible. And three, you need a nook. You need a place to go to. You need a desk, or you need a place that you will go to on a consistent basis. One of the reasons why people have difficulty reading the Bible is they don't do it consistently. They do it today, they do it a week later, and we know that it is the consistency of getting into God's Word that changes the way we live our lives. So three little things. Make sure you have a Bible that you can read and that you can understand, and there are just lots of them out there today. Make sure that you pick a time and you actually open the Word of God and read it. This book can be read in less than 72 hours. I don't recommend it all in one sitting, but you can read half the books of this Bible in less than 30 minutes, 26 of them in less than 15 minutes. So it's not an insurmountable task. It just takes a place, it takes the desire to do it, and it takes you doing it consistently.